Okay, so today we have Blondie, Heart of Glass. Now, Heart of Glass by Blondie here. There are several different versions of this song, many of which, some are like over 6 minutes, and then, some are close to 4 minutes and all this stuff. Anyway, so I went with this. It's a, I guess, a live performance. They probably, I'm guessing, lip sync it. But anyway, we're gonna get into this one, Blondie. I know a couple songs from Blondie, of course, Call Me. One way or another. But anyway, I don't know if I've heard this, so let's get into it. Talk about it after. Let's go. Blondie, Heart of Glass. So yeah, I'll have to say I have not heard that song, even though I know it's one of their most, best known songs. I mean, I'm surprised. I mean, I like, the live performance here. Just again, it was like the most viewed video kind of a thing. So I was like, well, I'll try to do a live performance, I guess, unless it gets blocked. But either way, I really enjoy how, you know, they're all kind of on their own stand, except for the, I think, two guitarists behind Blondie there, or behind Debbie Harry, I guess, either way. But yeah, and I just really like, you know, the dancing, and they all look so serious as well, which made me laugh. And I mean, the man, I don't know the names, but the man in the gray suit, you know, he was doing the kind of the, I don't know, just doing a little jig and stuff. And at one point, he like pointed his guitar at the camera, almost like, you know, a gun or something. It was just all kind of weird. And I really thought, you know, they'll kind of, it seemed like they were kind of doing it on purpose, trying to be kind of funny and look so serious or something. But anyway, I really enjoyed, I mean, the drum machine at the start. I mean, that was, you know, infectious, you know, through the whole way, through the whole song. Yeah. And I mean, friggin' Debbie Harry's vocals, I mean, it's so high pitched. I mean, like I said, probably I would say lip-synced here. And I mean, I liked when you had her singing and you could see in the background just the fingers plucking away on the guitar. And I don't know, I just really enjoyed that image there. And I mean, the camera, you know, the switching of the camera angles, whatever, friggin' changing it up like every millisecond really gets kind of hard on the eyes for a second, but going to each like member of the band, it's just like this is very late 70s, early 80s. I really enjoyed it. And of course, Blondie being, I think they said that, you know, even though they've had you know, kind of punk themes and you know, rock, whatever, they considered themselves to be new wave, which I mean, I love new wave, and I mean, one of my favorite bands, you know, the Cars being part of, I guess, the new wave movement of the late 1970s. But yeah, really enjoy the song. And again, her voice is just like so on point. I mean, the pitch is perfect. Pitch perfect. There you go. And I mean, it's just, but so, I don't know. It's just like a voice, a very distinct voice. I mean, good Lord. I don't know if I've heard anyone sing that high in a while. And just really enjoyed the song all the way through. And again, I really enjoyed, that's one thing I like about, doing, I guess, live things or whatever, reacting to live performances, because you see the band, you see what they do. And like I said here, I mean, the band members all kind of have their own little, I don't know, way of performing in front of cameras or whatever, and I just thought it was cool. I like the drummer as well. The drummer kind of just seemed low key. He just kind of seemed happy to be there, just doing his thing. I don't know. Anyway, getting into the about here on Genius, like you usually do on genius.com about the song. So, I mean, I guess I'll say off the top, you would imagine that the song is about a relationship, you know. I mean, yeah, good Lord. You know, right off the bat, when she says, "Once I had love and it was a gas," you know, gas being a fun time, I guess you would say, soon turned out to be hard of glass. But either way, like I said, let's get into the about. But I'm saying, you know, relationship involved here, obviously. So this is ranking number 255 and number 259 in 2017 on Rolling Stone's list of 500 greatest songs of all time. With its 1.3 million sales in the UK alone, okay, so we're giving the accolades right off the bat. Heart of Glass made Blondie one of the zeitgeist bands of the 70s. Initially called Once I Had a Love and referred to as the disco song, we'll get into that in a minute as well. It was one of the first Blondie songs that was written, albeit with a disco beat and a slower pace, until it was arranged and re-recorded as a more pop-oriented tune to sound the way it sounds now. According to Debbie Harry, who co-wrote the song with Chris Stein, the lyrics weren't about anyone. They were just a plaintive moan about lost love. So again, I mean, when you talk about love, you have so many different, I mean, areas you can go. It's just like, I mean, love's a huge thing that you can write about, obviously. But talking about the disco thing there, I did see, you know, like I said, there's so many versions of this tune. There was one just called Disco Version, and I was like, what is that? And I did see, you know, through my research here from, you know, Wikipedia and Song Facts and the YouTube comments and all that stuff, and Genius. I mean, the song, apparently some people thought that the song was, you know, kind of Blondie selling out, doing a disco tune. And I do know that a lot of people did not like disco. And there's that whole thing that disco died in like 1980 or something like that. There's a big event. I can't remember what it was all about. But yeah, it was like disco died. I can't remember what happened, why. But anyway, but yeah, I mean, and I did see, I'll actually hold the phone. I was just trying to find the quote here. It was from Chris Stein. And he was talking about how he always kind of wanted to do a disco song, and he had this quote saying about it. As far as I was concerned, disco is part of R&B, which I had always liked. So again, just talking about the disco controversy, as it says here on Wikipedia. There's a whole little section on the controversy and how, like I said, Blondie was, you know, at the forefront of New York's growing new wave music scene, and then being accused of selling out after releasing a disco song. And again, I don't hate disco myself. I mean, I mean, I don't listen to it often, but I mean, it's there, and I like some disco songs. I think they're fun, they're funky, you can get down to them. But I mean, if you see Blondie in a certain light, especially in the late 70s, and they release this, and it's like, what is this? I mean, I guess I can understand. But either way, I just like how Chris Simon was like, oh, I always kind of wanted to do this, and I did it, and then people didn't like it, but what the heck? So anyway. Talking about the members here, I do want to get into the credits, because I don't know everybody in the band except for Debbie Harry and Chris Stein. And just to add to what I said about Chris Stein, Jimmy Destri also said about the song. I feel like I'm just giving a bunch of quotes, but anyway, he said, Chris Stein always wanted to do disco. We used to do Heart of Glass to upset people. So I just like that, they were just doing their own thing. They didn't really care. But like I said, the credits here. So obviously, Debbie Harry on vocals, written by Debbie and Chris Stein. Keyboard, Jimmy Destri. I really enjoy the keyboards. Again, watching it live, I like how, he kind of counted it in after his little part. And I don't know. Again, it's just you get their, you get who they are through live performance. 12-string guitar, Chris Stein. Bass, Nigel Harrison. The bass was also, I feel like I didn't really appreciate it as much as I should have. But that was incredible as well, I felt. And then we go on the guitar as well. Frank, I want to say Infanti. Either way, there you go. And then Clem Burke on drums. What a name, Clem Burke. But shout out to Clem Burke as well. I don't know who did the, it's a drum machine at the start, so I don't know if anyone did it. But the drum machine was great as well. So yeah, I am also on Song Facts. Like I said, just a little bit more about the song, because I feel like I haven't, talked about the lyrics too much. But it says, Debbie Harry and Chris Stein, who were a couple when they wrote this, okay, so there you go, in early 1974. So they wrote this pretty early on, okay, shortly after they met, they wrote this. They didn't have a proper title for the song and would refer to it as the disco song. There we are again. Harry explained on a show, on the show Words and Music, lyrically, it was about a stalker who was pursuing me and Chris saved me from him. Okay, so from the genius part where it says it's just kind of like a love song about being lost or whatever, not much to it. Here, I guess it's about a stalker. That's what it's saying on Song Facts. But either way, goes on here again, Harry and Stein, Harry Stein, that sounds a person. Anyway, Harry and Stein wrote the song in their dingy New York apartment, and keyboardist Jimmy Destri provided the synthesizer hook. And the synthesizer hook as well. The synthesizers, were obviously, keyboard, synthesizer, whatever, big part of New Wave, and just had that sound. I think of like Moving in Stereo by the Cars. It's just, I don't know, that's what I think of when I think of like New Wave. It's just, it's like great, like I said before, it's just like an infectious sound that you like to hear again and again. Anyway, the result brought punk and disco together on the dance floor. Destri said, Chris always wanted to do disco, and then we did it. Okay, yeah, like I already said. But either way, it goes on. Also, Chris Stein was talking about, we didn't expect it to be that big. We only did it as a novelty item to put more diversity into the album. And for the musicians, I'm sure, the diversity, like you said, let's just try this. Let's do a song like this. All the other songs are kind of they're all kind of written in the same kind of rock, new wave thing. Let's do like a disco thing. Why not? And then that song ends up being, pretty big, and it ends up being, controversial with, hardcore fans and all that stuff. And, like he said there, it's like, we didn't expect it to be that big. But, again, the drum machine, and then Debbie Harry's just like insane vocals, delivered, just so, beautifully. Is what you could really say. It's just, the voice is just like, I've never heard a voice like this in my life before. But yeah. And especially when you compare it to a song like Call Me or One Way or Another, like the songs that I've heard, she has that kind of like vitriol voice, that goes almost guttural, and then here it's just like right high, it's just like all over the place. It's just like, whoa, I didn't expect that, but there it was anyway. So yeah, obviously really good song. I really didn't get into too much of the lyrics like I wanted to here, so I just do want to see if there's anything I can really say. Talking about the first chorus, in between, what I find is pleasing and I'm feeling fine. Love is so confusing, there's no peace of mind. If I fear I'm losing you, it's just no good. You teasing me like you do. Then, of course, the instrumental bridge, and then we go on. And then again, when she kept delivering the once I had love and it was a gas, soon turned out to be a heart of glass. Just how she delivered that line, just kind of smoothly, really. But there is one annotation here from that verse, you know, talking about saying something is a gas, a phrase synonymous with saying something is a lot of fun. She was just living in the moment in this relationship, but then it all suddenly ended up when the person shattered her heart. And it goes on about how the second line was supposed to be soon to turn out to be he was a pain in the ass. But Mike thought that might not play well on the radio, so he threw the phrase out and put in Heart of Glass, which everyone liked. Debbie worked it in as soon as it turned out he had had a heart of glass. That title was used in the song, and it goes on. It was in his book, Anatomy of a Song, How Blondie Created Heart of Glass. Or not a book, an article. But either way, really enjoyed the song. I feel like I mumbled through that annotation, but either way, they changed up a line. Radio friendly. I mean, you gotta be, and maybe, that's another point where they sold out, you know. Either way, really enjoyed the track. Blondie's voice was incredible. Each member of the band has their own kind of little, like I said, their own little unique style. They all seem to be having fun on the stage there, and obviously the song did very well, even with the controversy of fans. Either way, so yeah, thanks for watching, thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, and thanks for the suggestion about Blondie. Again, I've wanted to react to more people, I guess, more bands with, I guess, women in them, because I don't know, in 2020, in 2021, I just didn't really do that, I guess, I don't know, I just went by the wayside, but yeah, more women, and here we are. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you guys again soon.